Welcome to day 19 of Meerkat Manor. Joseph is first out tonight, scouting the area for prey. Last night, Joseph and Sebastian had a falling out over a vole. Oh, speak of the devil, here's Sebastian. The pair have never seen eye to eye within the group, and this could really be the last straw for Sebastian. Here's David, and oh look, Edwin, two senior members in the group, making sure that these two don't come to blows. The tension is really rising at Meerkat Manor as we await to see what happens next.
It's Big Brother's Big Mouth!
Pickling Jack.
I'm Joe, but welcome to Pickling Time.
Joining us tonight, is it one guest or are they two?
They're the thinking woman's us. It's Trevor and Simon!
They've never done a day's work in their lives and their benefits cheats. It's the studio audience. We'll be talking to that lot a little later. But first...
You know when people sometimes just overreact? What's he doing? What's that? Now, from the outside world, Jay looks like quite a big fella. Tall, lean, good-looking. When we went in the house, we realised it was all a televisual illusion. This is his actual size. Now, don't just sit there claiming you've got our names tattooed on your back. Actually do it.
Phone us, text us or email us your thoughts and messages via the website.
The housemates deserve every bit of success they receive. Jeremy, for example, can expect millions of pounds, scores of beautiful women and a jet-set lifestyle as a racing driver. However, in order to achieve this, he's going to have to drive around in circles for a few years. That's not easy. Jeremy, a nation salutes you. Watch this heart-rending documentary.
I'm Jeremy Metcalf. Thank you very much for joining us.
I don't talk to women much.
Well, we've been going with the girls quite well today.
They're so beautiful. My ad, it's stop.
Hello.
Get the fuck out.
You're a twat.
Amy, stop it. You're turning me on. Ice cream.
I think Amelia likes Jeremy.
Well, who wouldn't?
Feeling a bit loved up, are you?
Not really.
You are so full of shit.
Fit.
Birds.
I'll do whatever you want.
Jump.
The man in striped T-shirt, stand up. Yeah, you. Hurry up, quickly.
So if I annoy you, just fucking say it. I don't care.
Fashion is rubbish.
No, I'm just the butt of a joke.
I don't want to be pushed into it, because I get fucked off.
Please lie with your back
on the snow.
Also, congratulations to Jeremy for being the biggest knob.
Nice work, Jeremy.
We believe
we
it. John, our fellow housemate, is...
I'm old.
Don't even question my intelligence, OK? Because I'm more intelligent than you.
Are you sure you don't fancy it? Just nothing else explains why you have bickering fights.
Mate, can we please talk?
I don't want to talk.
Well, we can't be in a house... Oh, fucking hell.
You want more?
Good stuff. Good stuff. Now, we've called this discussion Tasty Tasty Jerry Jerry Tasty. He's Jerry Tasty. Or is he? It's a joy. Can I say it's
well,
a joy
don't question.
To have you both here?
No, before anything, okay. No, I'm not having that. Just don't question his intelligence.
Don't do that. Don't do that.
He's more intelligent than all of us are up together.
Don't belittle him.
He is one of the more controversial housemates in the house, isn't he?
Right.
Have you enjoyed seeing him in there?
Yeah, I just don't know which character he's going to be next. Sometimes he's Mr. Sweary, Mr. Kind of Hard. Now he's kind of Napoleon Dynamite, and he's all kind of, oh, God, God, everything's too much effort.
Yeah.
You know, he's just...
You don't know where you stand with him.
I have a theory about it.
Hit me with it.
Right. You remember Tom Cruise in Risky Business?
I'm aware of the fact.
And he's dancing around in his underpants. Well, I think a bit of his underpants, so to speak, flew off into a Petri dish and over the years formed into Jeremy. It's just a theory.
We're going to look into that right away. There's someone looking into it right now. They're on it right now, so we'll get an answer for that by the end of the show. He's got quite a few mood swings, hasn't he, in there? I mean, is that something we like in a housemate or do we not like that?
I don't like it because I've decided I don't like him. Okay. Based on not very much, really, but sure. I've just decided I don't like him. So his mood swings, no. He needs to calm down and sort out his eyebrows.
OK, what do we think out there, Matt?
What do we think of Jeremy? Any Jeremy fans in here?
Yes, I think...
No,
I think Jeremy's like a child. He's just trying to find where he fits in the house. You know, like, a child goes through different stages, and if there's a third child, then they have to be the boisterous one. I think he's just trying to find where he fits.
But he's made no real effort to bond with anybody, has he, apart from maybe Victor?
All what I can't understand is the heartthrob of him. What is going on? It's like two of the fittest girls in there are going for this rancid-looking thing. Where's that? Maybe the girls don't think that they're good enough for Anthony. That's my theory.
Girls, is he a dreamboat?
They're not dreaming because they can manipulate him. The others are too macho. But him, they could make him do
anything. I don't know about Jay as macho, really.
Yeah, but he's still a strong man. Jay, he's still got a strong identity. Him, he does anything anyone tells him to do, and the women like that.
Is the chemistry between him and Amelia real? No. What do we think?
Yes,
no?
His mum said it was. Yeah, definitely.
Anyone else, other than the two people that have already spoken on the show?
Does anybody like to talk?
Or the mutes
like
that are sat around about?
They're like a married couple.
Oh, yeah, it's like they've known each other for years, like they said in the VT.
You're talking about the bickering?
Yeah, I mean, they're just... I think they really like each other, but they're sort of... No,
isn't that just sexual tension, though?
Amy asked him, do you fancy her? And he said... Didn't answer the question straight away, no. He says, I can't. Not no, I hate her, I don't find her attractive. It was no, I can't.
Why did he say that? Why I can't?
Because he does fancy her.
It's like at school, you know. It reminds me of a school crush, you know. I just don't think he's got the nuts to...
Do we want to see him get it on?
He doesn't fancy her. He only said he liked her when he couldn't get around her. He wants to.
But would we as viewers like to see them two get it on?
No.
Yes.
No.
Why?
Yes.
Why?
I think he's rude.
Right.
He's horrible. He's aggressive. Yeah. And she's got a boyfriend. What's he playing at?
Well, but what's she playing at? More likely,
he's just the guy here would like to see them getting on.
I think they should get it on because they're like. They're the same as each other. They're just constantly going on at each other, so they're perfect for each other.
Can I interject?
Yes, I do.
I think we should see them get it on. What could be a better combination? Hang on a minute. What can be a better combination? An acrobat with a racing driver. He just stays like this. And it's just it's perfect.
It's a valid point. Now, we've got an email here that says... I love BB. I watch it every night. My fave's Jeremy, although he's always picked on and quite often looks bored. From Kat. Is he picked on? Is he picked on?
Yeah.
No?
Oh, yeah, he is. From, like, Russell Brand and the celebs. But that's because he is a good sport. You can't knock that. And he has got that side that is quite funny. But I just don't like him.
Well, why? If he's a good sport and he's quite funny.
No, yeah, things like that. But just the fact of the way he's with the girls, I just don't see the attraction.
Jealous.
Do you think he could go on and win it?
No!
No way at all? No chance?
No.
Well, there we go.
My God, the views expressed in that last debate were fierce. You lot could do this every day if you wanted. Hang on, most of you do. If you want to give us your views, don't come here every day. Please don't. Just pick up, dial and talk.
Jeremy took offence today at what he perceived to be an insult to his intelligence. So we're going to insult our audience's intelligence by getting them to attempt to spell the longest word they can from these nine letters. It's like vowels and consonants. This is a truly unique game on British television.
To be honest, we're only expecting four-letter words from this lot. So, for you at home, there will be a list of some of the most intelligent things what people have written on the ticker. It's the mouthpiece.
I have watched that greedy cow, Amy, eat non-stop for the last 1 hour on the night programme. She has not stopped eating.
Oh, dear. Amelia has to go on Wednesday, doesn't she? Pity she can't take that chinless wonder Jeremy with her, though, and it's got to be John to win, hasn't it? The one honest housemate left, John to win.
Will somebody please tell LaToya to wipe the corners of her eyes? Thank you.
You know what? I really hope that Amelia wins this because that poor girl has been picked on for nothing, and that wobbly head, Jeremy, since Victor's gone, has been nothing but nasty towards her and slimy. I can't stand her. Anyway, get wobbly head Bob out and get nasty Amy out and hope Amelia wins because that poor girl's just been picked on. Why? Because she's bendy and slim and pretty and gorgeous and glamorous. Bye.
OK, right, here we go. Has anyone got a nine-letter word?
Yes.
Who?
Yeah,
who?
Me.
Right.
Oh.
Ducklings. Ducklings. Wait. 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 There it is. Right, now, wait. Who's got ducklings? Stand up if you had ducklings.
Woo!
OK. Yeah. Trevor and Simon, you can't compete. This is for a lean, mean, fat-reducing grilling machine. Trevor and Simon, who's the winner? Pick someone. Who looks like they need a grill?
Who needs a grill?
Who needs a grill?
That one's got a big kiss on it, and it says, hi, kids.
Yeah, she's the winner.
Yes,
she is. Cats. All right, here's a nine-letter word for you. Right here, advertise. That's right, it's ad time. We'll see you after this. Bye!
Can a hijack ever be nice?
Yeah, definitely.
Welcome back. Still with us tonight, we've got Trevor and Simon. And they just won't take no for an answer. The studio audience. Yay! Now, tonight, there were three people who were fighting for the last available seat in the Big Mouth audience. They claim to be opinionated enough to take this throne, so we're going to put them to the test by playing Opinion Factor. I'd like to wish all three contestants all the Bradley luck in the world. James is backstage with our three contenders now. James Corden, are you there?
Hello, Matthew Horn, can you hear me?
I can, James Corden, hi.
Thanks, Matthew Horn. Now, I'm back here in the prop room at Big Brother. This is where all the tasks and everything gets worked out, and the tension back here is literally unbearable. These three guys want the seat in that audience more than you can ever, ever know. This is Opinion Factor. I'm going to ask each of them for an opinion on anything they want, and you will decide who gets that seat and this crown. Contestant number one, what's your name? Where are you from?
My name's Bob. I'm from Sidcup.
Bob from Sidcup. How long have you been having opinions?
About 26 years.
OK, will you give us your best opinion now in your own time?
My opinion is that they should stick the congestion charge right up Ken Livingstone's arse.
Political, controversial, that is what we're looking for. I can't believe what it's like back here. Contestant two, what's your name, where are you from?
My name's Danny and I'm from Reading.
OK, Danny, have you been... do you like giving opinions?
I love it, especially when I was in Sydney.
OK, well, so Sydney, a good opinion place. In your own time, give us your opinion.
I always wonder why people are always sat in their rooms debating why PS3s are better than Xbox 360s when the 360s are clearly better. I mean, come on. Well, where's the love?
Well,
where is the love?
I for one, wasn't expecting that kind of brand endorsement.
There's no love.
Shh.
All consoles are good. We should say that right now. These are not the opinions of Big Brother. Contestant number three, how are you?
Hi, I'm all right, thank you.
What's your name? Where are you from?
My name is Saeed, I'm from London.
OK, Saeed, have you got, like, a hard luck story you could give us just to win some more votes, like the girl on X Factor who found the letter from her dad when he was, you know?
Definitely.
Something like that. Have you got anything like that?
My opinion, basically.
Oh, OK, so you're just going to go straight for the opinion.
All right,
Saeed, that's what we want, someone who wants to give us straight the opinion.
I'm straight,
go for
it. Please, once again, leave Britney alone.
Oh, wow. Personal and from the heart. Now, the votes have been counted and verified. We can't take you back here any longer. Matt, please put two of these guys out of their misery. But over to you.
Right, well, it's between two of you. Number one, I think you'll find your opinion doesn't stand up to close scrutiny. I doubt I'll ever see you in the audience for a fully fledged TV show. Go home. Number two, I used to have your opinion. I have to say it's a personal favourite of mine. I think you carried it off with conviction. Number three, your opinion moved me. Could easily gain a very public following, but only one of you can come through to the studio and possibly one day make it onto a terrestrial TV audience. That audience hopeful is... Oh. It's number three, Saeed.
Yes!
Come on.
I literally got a semi. It's amazing. You're amazing.
Good luck.
Woo!
Now, fox hunting, badger baiting, and squirrel punching are three of my favourite pastimes. It's only joking, I love squirrels. I've had several as lovers. But last night, me and James saw a bare-knuckle fist fight between Jamelia and Martin Yol that literally rocked our world. Afterwards, Jamelia said, "This is nothing. If you want real action, salmon slapping's where it's at." Then Yol piped up, "Slapping? That's nothing. You should try smoking them." So off we went and double dropped some of those bad boys. This is the whacked out shit we came back with.
Hello,
celebrity was to hijack this factory, which celebrity would you like it to be?
Amy Winehouse.
Maybe Jamie Oliver. I like him.
Johnny Depp, more likely. Yeah, definitely.
David Tennant, Doctor Who. He's the Time Lord. Genius.
Which fish would you use to try and bribe a hijacker?
It'd have to be smoked salmon. Yeah, because, you know, I'm sure that if I gave him a smoked salmon, he'd have mercy on me and let me go.
A kipper.
Why?
Slap him around the face, threaten him with it.
Salmon?
Why?
Because it's tasty.
I suppose for multi-purposing tasks, octopus would be quite good.
I'd probably use some smoked cod's roe or Arbor Smokies, always good. Yeah, bribe them with that. Maybe some squid, yeah.
If a celebrity tried to hijack this factory, how would you react?
I'd probably let them get on board, definitely. Anything to get me out of the day's work.
I'd probably, I don't know, impress them with some muscles, some smoked muscles maybe.
Oh, great, that means we'd probably stop work.
Jay is truly a fashion Goliath, and with his raw lyrical genius, he's set to be bigger than Savage Garden. But since he's gone into the house, the world's gone shit. The international stock markets have suffered their worst opening to trading since records began, planes are dropping out of the sky, and there still isn't a Police Academy 8. The only possible explanation is that we've locked up a messiah. Watch this VT, during which we hotly anticipate a plague of locusts, or maybe some angry emails. Check this.
This is going to sound really bad, but I just know no one's name.
That is so shallow.
No, it's not!
Some girls envy me.
I'm Fab Man!
Do you know Marc Jacobs?
I do.
Oh, my God, I love him.
I love Jay so much.
Fierce. Now you're vulnerable.
You was easy when it came to men.
Loving it!
I'm loving it!
I'm gonna let him through.
Jay, I can't believe you just did that!
A thousand kisses from you.
I'm trying to capture the energy as opposed to actually looking. Everyone's fucking annoying me.
Ow! He dashed an apple in my face.
Oh, yeah.
Jay,
you're a fucking genius, mate.
Yeah.
We're hijacking the house today.
I guess because they couldn't get anyone else.
Pretty much.
Why would someone pay just under a grand for a pair of knickers?
It's high fashion.
Hi.
Excellent. Good to see you looking fantastic.
Oh my God, did you see him back?
What a legend.
Yes, Jay. We've decided to call this discussion Jape Fear or Jape of Good Hope. Not bad. What do we think of Jay?
Jape of Good Hope.
Yeah?
Yeah, do I have to pick one of the
You love him, you
I'm
love
chosen
him.
To, no, I quite like him, because, I mean, I thought that he seems to apply himself very much to everything he does. He seems dedicated. And he made that dress for Callista out of, what? excuse me.
You get so much airtime.
I liked that dress. I know you are a fashion expert and you know all these things. Well, you know, I like Miss Piggy. You know, we all have our own tastes.
But
Miss
he doesn't
Piggy,
take himself too seriously, does
no, he?
Is that part of his appeal?
He carries off everything with style. Like, even when he was a twitcher, he looked stylish. He made himself look like Howard from the Halifax ads with those glasses on.
Yes.
And it was, he's good. He's you know, he's all right.
Oh, he wears odd jumpers, though.
He kind of gets
a jumper
on...
that zips up, like, right up here. I don't know what kind of jumper that is.
It's a fashion jumper.
It's what it is.
It's a fashion sweater. It's a fweater. So, any Jay fans over there?
Are any Jay fans? Are you a Jay fan?
Not really.
Why?
Well, I don't know. He's just not anything. Yeah, bland.
Really?
Very, yeah.
I like him. I think he's big fun. He doesn't take himself too seriously. No. He seems like he's got a good... Anyone a Jay fan here?
Yeah, I am.
Good. Yes. Yeah.
Come on, I think the house would be totally boring without him.
Yeah.
Don't you think? He just brings so much...
Is he really a fashion designer? Do we know this for a fact?
Yeah,
because
somebody throws
on something that might vaguely, you know, look like a fashion designer...
Yeah, I don't think they're judging him on that. I think he's designed stuff at, like, New York Fashion Week.
Has he really?
Yes.
Oh, well, sorry,
they didn't just pick them at random, people that look good and go, yeah, you can do fashion. Do we enjoy it, like, when he makes little snide comments and stuff like that? Do we enjoy that? Yeah.
That's my only favourite thing. I don't personally like him, but my favourite thing his one, like, with Russell Brand asking about the whole Kate Moss thing. He knows the right questions to ask, but he was out of order to you yesterday when he said... Are you the only people that we could get on to?
No, it was funny and actually true.
No, it's not.
Now, listen, fashion and music are two things which almost interlink, OK? And we've got someone on the phone right now who has actually never watched the show. He has no idea what we're talking about, but...
What he does know about is music.
Banging beats. On the phone, we got Brandon Block. Hey, Brandon,
hey,
hi!
Hey, Brandon!
Are you all right?
Hello,
Jack. How are you doing? Are you well?
Very good, very good.
Whereabouts are you at the minute?
Beef up.
I'm in the middle of a poker game, believe it or not.
Of course you are, of course you are. Now, listen. We've made a track, right, with Jay called Fierce, 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 Now You're Vulnerable. I'm sure you've heard it on the underground scene. We're going to play you a bit now, and we want your honest assessment of whether it could be a hit or not.
Right,
give us the music. Let's do it. Fierce, 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 now you're vulnerable. Okay. Brandon, what do you think?
Who actually made that?
We did.
Oh, you lot?
Yeah. Is it a hit?
In that case, it's fantastic.
Yeah. Me, you and Jay, we're going to meet up after and discuss getting that out there. Thank you so much, Brandon. That's fantastic.
Cheers,
Brandon
Block,
everybody. What a great guy. Right, listen, guys. Who's going to go tomorrow?
Amelia!
Yeah. Really? Really? Yeah. Trevor Simon, who's going to go? Forget it.
The
final word to Simon.
Sorry, who's going to go?
Gonna go?
Amelia.
Why?
Because she does too many stretches all day long.
That's great. That's all we've got time for, guys.
That's for us tonight, yeah. We've just got time to say a big thanks to our guests, Trev and Simon.
Amelia.
Amelia.
And that's waiting outside. The engineer is the studio audience.
Amelia and Latoya face eviction from the Big Brother house. Who goes? You decide.
To evict Amelia, call 09011-21-2204. To evict Latoya, call 09011-21-2209.
At least 10p from each call will be donated to charity, details of which can be found at channel4.com/Big Brother.